Welcome, lifters and ravers, to another stretch and flow class. Just a little bit of yoga to get down, get into our mobility a little bit, and just like calm out while we're having our reset before we go back into the lifting and the running around. So hopefully this is gonna be helpful just to chill out a little bit. And yeah, thanks for practicing with me. If you just wanna all start finding a simple child's pose, just sit on your heels, hands reach forward, maybe even stay on the fingertips of your hands. Just walk the fingertips a little bit farther forward. Take a deep breath in here. And then on your exhale, just allow the chest to sink down towards the mat. Staying on the fingertips, think there's little cupcakes under your hands. And you have to push the fingers into the mat to make space so you don't squish the cupcake. Maybe even walk the fingertips a little bit farther forward, starting to feel that lengthening through the arms and the side of your body. And then see if you can soften a little bit more on the exhale. From here on your next inhale, just walking the hands over towards the right side. Hands can go flat now. Maybe even the left hand pushes into the right hand. And just see how that changes when you push the left hand into the right. See what happens to your left shoulder, how it rolls down the side and deepens the stretch into your left side body. Take another deep inhale into the left side of your ribs. And on your exhale, slowly walk back to center. From here, walking over all the way to the left side. Again, hands can go flat. Maybe the right hand pushes into the left, deepening that side stretch. Take another nice deep inhale. And exhale, slowly coming back to center. From here, pushing to the top of your feet, coming to a tabletop position, hands under shoulders, knee under your hips. And already push the mat away, getting this engagement through the fingers, grabbing the mat and just taking little circles over your wrists. And then just notice if you're sore, maybe this is already a bit harder. Maybe you start with tiny little circles and make them a little bit bigger. And then just see if you can notice what happened to your shoulders. Are your shoulders coming up to your ears? If so, can you wrap them away and push the mat away a little bit more? Make sure you do circles both ways. Go left and right. Maybe those circles start to become bigger. Maybe there are less circles, maybe they're more figure eights, or just sort of a more fluid movement in your spine. Then slowly starting to find a central position. Again, pushing the hands into the mat, getting a little rounding sensation through the shoulders, lifting the heart forward, lengthening the tailbone back. Then from here, try and get really stable in your whole core. Wrapping the shoulders away from the ears, really pushing the mat away, and then shifting all the weight into your right hand. Then from here, push the right hand into the mat a little bit more and find that place where the left hand becomes almost weightless and hovers over the mat. Nothing else moves, it's just the left hand just slightly lifting off the mat. And then your inhale, reach the left hand forward. Everything else stays exactly where it is. On your exhale, the hand comes down. Let's do two more of those. Inhale, reach the left hand forward. And exhale, the left hand comes down. Last time, inhale, left hand forward. And then exhale, left hand comes down. Let's try this one more time. Keep that weight in your right hand. This time, reach the left hand and the right foot. Maybe the right foot still touches the mat. Maybe it lifts off and kicks back. And then exhale, coming all the way down. Again, see if you can stay stable in your core and your shoulder, so you keep that engagement through the right hand. Inhale, left hand forward, right foot back. And exhale, coming back down. Last one, left hand, right foot. And exhale, back down. If it feels good, roll your shoulders out before you come all the way down. Resetting again for the other side. So this time all our weight shifts into the left hand. Make sure you get that nice engagement, protraction through the shoulders, meaning the shoulders roll away from the ears. And we get that little ballooning feeling between our shoulder blades. Keep pushing that left hand a little bit more into the mat, and then inhale, reach the right hand forward. Exhale, replace the right hand. Inhale to reach. And exhale to replace. Last one. Inhale, reach the right hand. Keep pushing the left hand down. And right hand comes down. This time, right hand, left foot, reaching as far as you can. Maybe the left foot lifts off. And exhale, replace. Just figure out how much you're wobbling. It's no good or bad. Reach a little bit more, push the left hand a little bit more. And exhale, replace the hand and foot. Last one, reach the right foot, right hand, left foot. Reach really far and wide, maybe lift, take another breath up here. And exhale, slowly coming back down. So from here, tuck your toes. Keep pushing both hands into the mat now, and then lift your knees off the mat, just about an inch. And then see if you're really rounding into the back. Can you lower the knees, lengthen the back so you're heart reaches forward, your tailbone reaches back. Your belly button draws in, up and up towards the spine. And if it gets hard, breathe a little bit more. Take a deep inhale here. And exhale, push back, find your downward facing dog. Have a little walk out, right foot, then the left. Bend one knee deeply, lengthen the other leg as far as it's comfortable. And then slowly starting to find a neutral position. From here, think about lengthening through the spine. So maybe your knees have quite a deep bend, but your tailbone reaches up. So you have one long line from your fingers through your shoulders to your tailbone. Maybe even bend the knees a little bit deeper, allowing the back spine to lengthen a bit more. And then only maybe you start to extend the knees again, if you can keep that long feeling through the spine. From here, take a little nice deep bend, and then inhale, reach the right foot up towards the sky. On your exhale, knee comes into the chest, squeeze it into the chest, and then step between your hands. We're in a low lunge on the right side. Drop the left knee on top of the left toes. Fingertips clasp together, reach the hands over your head, and then fold deep into your hip. Anjaneyasana on the right side, lift a little bit higher through the fingertips, if they're clasped or maybe even away from each other, and then see if you can fold a little bit deeper, straight opening here through the left hip. Taking one more inhale here, and then exhale, hands come down to the mat, step to the top off the mat, left foot meets the right. For a little ragdoll, side to side, maybe even hold opposite elbows. Just shake it all out. Shake your head no, nod your head yes. Then letting go of your hands and roll up one vertebra at a time, coming up to stand. If your shoulders are nice, little roll up, back and down. One of those, up, back and down. And then shake it all out. Get your toes to touch, and then on your inhale, hands come up, look up. On your exhale, nice soft knees as you bend forward. Inhale, finding your long flat back, hands on the shins. And exhale, connect your hands, step your left foot, then your right foot back into your plank. Then stay here, push the mat away on your inhale, and then your exhale, lower your knees, chest, chin, all the way down. Hands come forward, lift your hands, lift your heart, find your cobra. Tiny movement. And exhale, come down first, push back. Child's pose, down dog. Take a deep breath here. And a long exhale. Then lift your left leg up on your inhale. Knee to chest and stepping through, left foot between the hands. Lower your right knee, untuck the right toes. Hands come up, lift up. Anjaneyasana on the other side. Again, lifting through the hands, maybe they're clasped, maybe they're parallel, and then sink a little bit deeper in your hips. Feeling that stretch through the right hip flexor now. reaching up a little bit higher through the fingertips so you're not crunching the back. The back should feel nice and spacious as we maybe sink a little bit deeper in our hips. Last inhale here, and then exhale, hands come down, step the right foot next to the left, and find your forward fold. Take a little sway side to side, and then let the hands go, roll up all the way, one vertebra at a time. And exhale, hands to heart center. So two more rounds, inhale, look up, and exhale, as we hinge from the hips, long clap back. Halfway lift, inch or inhale. And exhale, connect the hand, step back, left foot, followed by the right. Inhale into plank, push the mat away, draw your belly button in, and exhale, lower your knees, chest, chin all the way down. Hands come forward, lift your hands, lift your heart. And exhale, come down first, child's pose, down dog. Take a deep breath here. And a long exhale. And inhale, lifting your right leg up, knee to chest, step through. Drop your left knee, untuck your left toes. Inhale into your Anjaneyasana. Lift your heart a little bit higher. Lift your fingertips a little bit higher. Maybe sink down into that hip flexor. See if you can lift out of your low back so you're not crunching into your low back. You're lifting the heart up. And on your exhale, hands meet the right foot. Left foot steps next to the right. Have a forward fold. Rolling all the way up. Shoulders up, back and down. And hands come into heart center. One more round, inhale, look up. And exhale as you hinge from the hips, falling back down. Halfway lift on your inhale. And exhale, connect your hands, step back, find your plank. Stay here, inhale, push the mat away. And exhale, lower your knees, chest, chin all the way down. Hands come forward, lift your hands, lift your heart, cobra. And exhale, come down first, child's pose, down dog. For a little step out, side to side. And then on your inhale, left foot lifts. Knee to chest, step through. Lower your right knee, untuck your right toes. Inhale, lift the hands up. Maybe go for the clasp, and then sink into your hips. Again, can you lift from the chest? So you're not crunching into your low back. Maybe you don't bend backwards that much. Think about up more than back. And then allow yourself to sink into your hips. Take another inhale here, lift. And exhale, hinge forward, step the right foot next to the left. Find your forward fold. Slowly rolling up all the way to standing. And exhale, hands into heart center. Last round, inhale, lift up. And exhale as you hinge from the hips. Long halfway lift on your inhale, hands on shins, and exhale, connect the hands, step into your plank, hold. Push the mat away, find your long plank first, and then exhale, lower your knees, chest, chin. Hands come forward, lift your hands, lift your heart. And exhale, come down first, push back, child's pose. Down dog. Flowing it through this time, inhale, right foot up, knee to chest, stepping through. Lower your left knee, lower, untuck your left toes, reach the hands up. And exhale, maybe sink into that right hip. Feeling the left hip flexor stretch nice and long, reaching a little bit higher. And then maybe you sink a little bit deeper. One more inhale here. And exhale, hinging forward, stepping to the top of the mat. Find your forward fold. Rolling up on your inhale. And hands come to our center. Last side, reach up. And exhale as you hinge from the hips, soft knees. Inhale, hands to shins, long flat back. And exhale, connect your hands, step back, find your plank. Inhale into plank, push the mat away. Exhale, lower your knees, chest, chin all the way down. Hands come forward, lift your hands, lift your heart. And exhale, come down first, push back, child's pose, down dog. Lift your left leg on your inhale, knee to chest, roll through, step between the hands. Lower the right knee, untuck the right toes, coming all the way up high lunge. And then sinking a little bit deeper into that hip flexor stretch. One more inhale, lifting through the fingertips. And exhale, hinging forward, stepping the right foot to the left. Find your forward fold. Have a little wiggle side to side and then slowly roll all the way up to standing. Give your shoulders a nice big roll. And exhale, hands into heart center. So you should be a little bit warm now. You can get a bit more into the fun, a bit of balancing and a bit of stretching, it'd be nice. So from here, before we do anything else, just find yourself at the top of the mat, get your feet to connect together, and then just close your eyes. See if you can slow the breath down just a little bit. Can you push into your big toe and your little toe? And then feel like your knees are always drawing up towards the pelvis. You're squeezing your thighs together and rotating them back ever so slightly. Lifting through the chest, lengthening down through the tailbone. Hands are on either side, pinky fingers spinning in, thumbs spinning out. And you feel this lifting sensation through the top of your spine. And see if you can inhale to lengthen up and exhale to ground down a little bit deeper. Taking one more deep breath here, just grounding down. And then maybe even with your eyes closed still, start to reach your hands out to the side and lift them up overhead. And then see if you can come with me with your eyes closed, slowly hinging forward, bending in your knees, finding your forward fold. See if it gets a little bit wobbly, maybe keep your eyes closed. Then take your halfway lift, reach your heart forward, nice long back, hands on your shins. And then connecting the hands and see, maybe you can even do it with your eyes closed still, stepping back into your plank. From here, maybe open your eyes, maybe keep them closed. Just pushing to your toes, coming slightly with your shoulders over your hands and then start to bend your elbows. Find your chaturanga. Roll over your toes, coming to your up dog. Reach your heart forward, push the top of your feet into the mat. And then exhale, push back, find your downward facing dog. From here, lifting the right leg back up, finding your three-legged dog. And then rolling forward, knee to chest, really squeezing the knee into the chest, pushing the mat away. Squeeze the knee into the chest a little bit more, push the mat away a little bit more, making more space. And then finding space for the foot between your hands. From here, both hands reach forward, finding like a high lunge, but find it in a diagonal. So finding one diagonal line that goes from the fingertips through the body to the heel. And on your exhale, hands come into heart center. Reach the heart forward a bit more, and then your next exhale, twist your left elbow towards your right knee. And then if you want to have it a bit more relaxing, stay here. Keep breathing, keep lifting the heart forward on your inhale, and maybe on your exhale, you twist a little bit more towards the ceiling. If you want to have a little bit of a play, look down towards your right thumb. Inhale, reach the hands, right big toe. Inhale, reach the hands forward, back into the diagonal. And then your exhale, stand up on your right leg. So the right foot stays where it is, your left knee comes into your chest, reaching the hands up towards the ceiling. If you're still with me and this is fun, take your right hand on your left knee and your left hand opens up towards the wall behind you. So you're twisting into the other direction. That left knee still lifts up, that right big toe keeps pressing down into the mat below you. Lifting your heart a little bit higher. And exhale here. On your inhale, both hands come back overhead, square the shoulders over your hips. Then slowly hinge forward, kick the left foot back. Rebend into the right knee and then land back down in that twisted lunge. So your left foot is back, your left elbow is on the right knee, just as we started. Let's try it one more time. Inhale to reach the hands forward, square the shoulders over your hips. Then exhale, left knee comes to the chest, push the right big toe down as much as you can. If you're bobbling, this is great. If you're falling over, even better. Stay here, right hand comes on the left knee, left hand reaches back towards the wall behind you. Take an inhale here. Slow exhale, keep pushing that right foot down. Inhale, reach both hands up, square the shoulders over your hips. And then exhale, hinging forward, rebending into the right knee, step the left foot back. Find your lunge on the other side. And then if you've stayed here, slowly find ourselves again, reaching forward in that long diagonal lunge. And then exhale, opening into warrior two. So your left foot is perpendicular to the mat. Both hands reach away from you. We're nice and deeply bent in that right knee. So try to find the 90 degree angle in that right knee, reaching the hands forward. And then without copying me, just check in. Are you leaning forward or are you leaning back? Can you find your shoulders over your hips and only then rebend into that knee? From here, reach the right hand forward and then your right elbow comes just above your right knee. Left hand comes down and then reaches forward into an extended side angle pose. Again, we're making one long diagonal line through the left side of the body. And then just see if you can take a bit of weight out of your right elbow. Maybe the right elbow floats just over the right knee. Maybe the right hand comes parallel to the left. Take one inhale here. And exhale, coming all the way back into your warrior two. Reaching forward with your right hand, flipping the palm, and then on your exhale, reverse the warrior, left hand on the left thigh or shin. Take a deep inhale into the right side of your ribs. And exhale, windmill the hands down, step back, find your plank. Inhale here in your plank. Come slightly over your wrists, and then exhale, bend the elbows into your ribs. Rolling over the toes, finding your up dog. And exhale, push back, downward facing dog. Take a breath here. Slowly exhale. In your next inhale, lift the left leg up. Rolling forward, knee to chest, really squeeze the knee into the chest, push the mat away with your hands, squeeze the knee into the chest a little bit more, and then step through. They're in a low lunge on the other side, reaching both hands forward on your inhale, finding that diagonal shape again. Reaching a little bit longer through the fingertips and maybe kicking that right heel back a little bit. And reaching one more on the inhale and then exhale, hands coming to heart center. Right elbow finds something close to the right knee. Maybe it hooks, maybe it floats just over the knee. The important thing is here, we're nice and long through the spine. And then only we twist into the side. So again, maybe you stay here if it's too much, maybe even lower your left, right knee. If you wanna come and play. Next inhale, square the shoulders over your hips. Reach the hands forward. Get all the weight into the left knee. And then slowly stand up, right knee into the chest. If you're wobbling, this is part of the game. Left hand meets the right knee, right hand reaches back behind you, finding a twist in the other direction. Again, this is where I fall on my face. So if you do too, we're all part of the same game. Inhale, both hands overhead, shoulders are square with the hips. And on our exhale, we're hinging forward, rebending into the left knee, step back the right foot, and find your twist over to the left side. Right elbow, somewhere around the left knee. Maybe it hovers, maybe it hooks. Take a deep breath here. Slow exhale. Inhale to square the shoulders with the hips and reach the hands forward. Put all the weight into your left foot and then take the right knee into your chest. Left hand meets the right knee, right hand goes back. Thinking a bit less, just trying it. Again, if you topple out, perfectly fine. Inhale as our hands come overhead. Exhale as you hinge forward, kick the right foot back, rebend into the left knee. Find our twist the last time. Take one more breath. And then exhale, squaring the shoulders, reaching forward into our diagonal line and opening up into our warrior two. So again, maybe you have to walk your feet out a little bit more, rebending into that left knee, finding that 90 degree angle in the left leg, reaching the fingertips away from us. And to see if your shoulders are up by the ears, can you draw them down towards the mat and then away from your ears? Inhale as you lengthen forward and exhale as the left elbow comes to the left knee, right hand comes down and forward. Reaching again through that one long diagonal line on the right side of your body. Reaching a little bit more. And then maybe in your exhale, you spiral the chest ever so slightly more to the ceiling. Then see if you can take the weight out of your left elbow. Maybe the left elbow hovers just over the knee. Maybe the left hand comes parallel to the right. One more inhale here. Slow exhale. And your inhale, the right hand pulls you back up into your warrior two. Reaching forward with the left hand, flipping the palm, and then exhale, reversing the warrior. Right hand on the right thigh or shin. Take a deep inhale into the left ribs. Then exhale as you windmill the hands down. Step back, find your plank. Come forward over the shoulders over the wrist. And then exhale, bending your elbows. Rolling over the toes, lift your heart forward. Push into the top of your feet. And exhale, roll back. Find your downward facing dog. Have a little walk out side to side. And then getting ready for the more chilled part of this class. Take a nice deep bend in the knees and step your right foot to the left hand, the left foot to the right hand, and just sit down. So that's always a funny one for me. The right, the left, to see where you're at, how that felt, and then finding yourself into a comfortable seat. So from here, just gonna have a simple forward fold. So if you're really stiff in your hips, might be nice to have a little pillow or something to sit on, just so you're a little bit higher up. So a pillow, a block, a book, something under your hips can be quite nice. Then just taking both your legs parallel. And then just see what happens when you flex your toes towards your face and kick the heels away. Again, for some of us, this might be really hard already, so you maybe have a little bend in the knees. Either way, when you're ready, reach your hands up towards the ceiling and then exhale, hinging forward as far as you can without rounding into your back. So see if you can keep that low back nice and flat, reaching probably more up than forward. See if you can push the chest a little bit farther forward, and then only maybe you hinge a tiny bit more. Just staying here for a breath or two. Reach the chest forward, reach the fingertips forward, and only maybe you hinge a little bit deeper. Taking one more breath here. Then exhale, allowing the hands to fall down anywhere on your mat. Just making it a little bit easier for support. See if you can keep that spine nice and long for just another breath or two. If at any point you want a bit less, bend your knees a little bit. If you want a bit more, flex the toes towards your face and push the knees down, but just using the muscles of your leg. Inhale as you reach the chest towards your toes. And then maybe on your exhale, you start to round through the spine. Just letting everything go. Maybe even closing your eyes. Taking a few simple deep breaths. The inhale reaches the chest forward. And the exhale softens everything just a little bit. And slowly walking your hands back up towards your hips. Give your legs a little shake. If you take your hands behind you for support. Then leaving your right leg out long, take your left foot and put it on your right thigh. Maybe on the shin if the thigh is not quite accessible today. And then reach your hands over yourself again. And on your exhale, see if you can rotate your chest towards the right foot. So we're not in the middle, we're squaring the shoulders towards the right foot. From here, lift one more time and then on your exhale, coming forward. Again, see if you can stay up on your fingertips, lifting your chest towards your toes. And same thing, if you want a bit more, flex your toes towards your face. If you want a bit less, have a little bend in your right knee. Take another deep inhale, lifting the chest forward. And exhale, maybe you come all the way down, rounding through the spine if that feels nice. If you go from a nice long spine to a rounded one, just notice how that changes the feeling in your body. Long, deep breaths in and out through the nose. And then on your next inhale, slowly starting to come, walking up, hands towards the hips. Take the left knee into your chest, give it a nice squeeze, and then step the left foot over the right. From here, left hand reaches up behind you, and the right arm just kind of gives that left knee a big hug. So you're really hugging that knee into your chest, lifting your chest up, using your left hand for support to lift yourself a little bit higher. And then maybe if it's comfortable on your neck, your gaze goes over the left shoulder. If that starts to feel bad on your neck, just look straight ahead. If that knee a little bit more of a squeeze, lift the chest a little bit higher. Then when you're ready, coming back to center, take your knee into your chest, step the foot in front of you, lengthen the left leg out, give your both your legs a little shake. Then changing to the other side, taking the right foot into your thigh or shin, and then setting up for the other side. Okay, we're reaching our hands over ourselves, and then our exhale, twisting ever so slightly to the left, so your shoulders are square to the left foot. Lift a little bit higher, and then hinging forward on your exhale. Same thing if you want less, bend the left knee. If you want more, flex the left toes towards your face. And then see if you can lift your heart up and forwards before you hinge down. So we still keep length through the spine. Taking one more breath here. And then maybe in your exhale, slowly start to round through the spine, coming out to your forearms or fingertips, just allowing the forehead to fall down towards your shin or knee. And just notice how that changes the feeling of the stretch. Taking one more deep breath here. And on your exhale, slowly walking yourself back up. Take your right knee into your chest, give it a little squeeze, and then step your right foot over the left. Your right hand reaches up and behind you, your left hand, left arm gives your right knee a big squeeze. So squeezing that knee into your chest with your left arm, and then using the right hand to push you away from the ground, lengthening through the spine. And just keep squeezing that knee into your chest, giving yourself a little bit of height, a little bit of lift, and then only maybe you fall ever so slightly deeper into the twist. Deep long inhale through the nose and slow exhales through the nose. Then when you're ready, slowly letting go of the knee. Take your right foot back over, lengthen it out, give it a little shake. Taking the pillow away if you have it. And then just laying all the way down towards the mat. From here, taking your right knee into the chest, give it a little squeeze. And then put the right ankle just above the left knee. So you have a little figure four. The right hand goes through the whole of the figure four. Left hand goes around the left knee. Just squeezing the thigh towards your face. Again, if this is not accessible, maybe hold your thigh rather than your shin, finding somewhere to hold on to. And then just gently pulling the left leg towards your chest. Your neck is long. The shoulders are away from your ears. Gently draw your left knee closer to your chest and then push the right knee away from you. If it feels funny on your knee at any point, just give a little bit of slack. Maybe don't go quite as far. Just feeling the opening into the hip. Take in another inhale. And then slowly letting go, stepping the left foot back down, stepping the right foot back down. Taking the left knee into your chest, give it a little squeeze. And then put the left ankle just on top of the right knee. Left hand goes through the figure four, right hand goes around. Either holding on the shin or your thigh, drawing that right knee into your chest. The left knee pushes away from you. The left toes flex towards the left knee. And then maybe in your exhale, you draw your right knee a little bit closer. Again, just finding how much is good for you today. It doesn't always have to be a crazy amount of stretch, just finding where it feels good. If your left elbow reaches the left knee, maybe you use the elbow to push the knee away just a little bit. Taking one more breath here. And slowly letting go of your right leg, stepping the right foot down, stepping the left foot down. From here, we're going to take bridge. So we're gonna have both hands on either side of our body. Our feet are about hip width apart and we can tickle the back of our heels with our fingertips. So you might have to step the feet a little bit closer if you can't quite reach. Then from here, just start to lift your tailbone off the mat. Send your knees away from your face. Lift the tailbone a little bit higher, squeeze the glutes a little bit, and then send the knees away from your face a little bit more. Then without moving the feet stay glued to the mat. Think about drawing the feet towards your face. Just that little engagement through the legs, lengthening your spine, sending the knees away a little bit farther. And see if you can lift your hips a little bit higher, but keep that engagement, sending the knees away, lifting the hips, sending the knees away, lifting the hips. Take a deep breath in, maybe lift your chest a little bit higher, lift your hips a little bit higher. And then your exhale very slowly, start to roll down through the top of your spine, through the middle of the spine. slowly coming into the lower spine. And at the very last, your tailbone touches down. Just allow the knees to fall in towards each other, have a second to breathe. Then we'll go one more time. Knees are parallel to the hips. Lift your tailbone. Send your knees away from the face. Lift your tailbone a bit higher. Send the knees away from the face. Use your hands for support. Squeezing the glutes a little bit, sending the knees away from your face. Drawing the feet ever so slightly towards your face. And then if you want a little bit more, clasp the hands behind your back and start to walk your shoulders in towards each other. So you can push the forearms into the mat, lifting a bit higher through the chest, getting a little bit of a stretch through our pecs. Lifting a bit more, pushing those hands and forearms down. Lifting the knees away from the face. Little activation in the glutes, not too much. Inhale into your chest, lift a little bit more. And then when you're ready, slowly letting go of the clasp of the hands, hands on the mat, and very slowly roll down. Top of the spine, middle of the spine, slowly curling down. Tailbone is the absolute last thing that touches the mat. Then just take the feet about hip width apart or mat width apart and allow the knees to fall in towards each other. Make a little tent. And on your exhale, just allow both knees to fall over to the right side. And maybe your arms go straight out to the side. Just finding a simple spinal twist. Maybe this is already enough. If you want a little bit deeper of a twist, just take your right foot and rest the right ankle just above the left knee. Just allowing gravity to deepen the twist ever so slightly. No pushing, no using your muscles, just allowing gravity to weigh down the knee ever so slightly. Long, deep breaths. And if your right ankle is on the left knee, slowly take it down onto the mat. Get both your knees back to the middle. Maybe have a little wiggle side to side. Then allow the knees to fall over to the left side. Again, same thing. Maybe this is enough. Maybe the left ankle rests just above the right knee. And maybe even the neck rolls over to the right side. Just finding the twist on the other side. Long, deep breaths. Very simple, nothing to do. Take one more deep breath. Then slowly release the left foot from the right knee if you have it. Come back to center. Just give yourself a nice big squeeze. Rocking side to side, your knees towards your armpits. Maybe you hold both knees in your hands, just having a little shake side to side. And from here, just taking opposite hands on, taking the hands on your shins, finding a happy baby pose, just holding your shins, maybe the outside of the feet, and just drawing the knees towards your armpits. Again, they don't have to come very low. Just let them float somewhere midair. See if you can just roll your lower back out on the mat. And then letting go, give yourself a last big squeeze. Take your knees into your chest. Take your face towards your knees and start to squeeze everything you can. Squeezing your toes, squeezing your fingers, your arms, your legs, your abs, your shoulders, your... Squeeze everything a little bit more, squeeze your face. And then let it all go. Send the feet to the corners of the mat. Allowing the hands to fall down on the side. Just take a moment to feel your body on the ground. And just set the intention to do absolutely nothing for the next couple of minutes. Just allowing everything to be as it is. Not having to change anything. And then just come to scanning your body, starting from the top of your crown, top of your head, feeling your face, your cheeks, back of your head and your neck, feeling into your throat and your clavicles, your chest and your shoulders. And as you scan through the body, just notice what those parts of the body feel like. No need to change it, just observing. Trickling from your shoulders into your arms. Feeling your upper arms, your elbows, your wrists and your hands. Feeling all 10 fingers. And traveling back up the arms, forearm, upper arm, chest and shoulders. Feeling your heart center. Then sinking down into your abs and your lower back. Your inner organs, your groin, your buttocks. Feeling your thighs. Your knees, your shins. Feeling your ankles and your feet. Feeling all 10 toes. Then feeling your whole body together, all the way from the toes to the hips, the shoulders, the fingers, your chest and your head. Just observing, noticing. Being grateful for the body that allows you to do so many things. And slowly start to deepen your breath. Sending your breath down to your toes and your fingers. Deep inhale, really filling your chest, filling your tummy. Maybe open the mouth and allow it to sigh out. Maybe have a little stretch. Maybe you roll your neck from one side to the other. Then at your own time, just take your knees into your chest, give them a last nice squeeze. Then just roll over to your favorite sides. Make yourself up to a seated position, maybe if you have your eyes closed, if you can. Just when you get there, any seated position is fine.
Let's take your hands into heart center, thumbs on your chest. Allow your chin to fall down a little bit. Just taking that moment to be grateful. Grateful for the people that make your days a little bit nicer. Grateful for your teachers, the people, and the moments that you learn from every day. And being grateful for yourself, that you make space and time to practice, to work out, to reset so you have energy to give to others again. Thank you so much for practicing with me today. And have a wonderful week. See you soon. Lifters, ravers, flowers, and stretchers. Thank you very much. Hope that was nice.